Most people get scared when they think about removing their appendix, and it is not for nothing. Suddenly, an intense pain takes over your body, and at the hospital, the doctors find out that a surgery is needed. Did you know that the remains of feces and undigested food are considered to be the cause of this inflammation? So, removing your appendix may prevent a generalized infection. Who would say that this small organ, whose function is still a mystery, is linked to Parkinson's disease? According to research published in Science Translational Medicine, people who had their appendix removed had less chances to develop this neurodegenerative disease. This connection is explained by the accumulation of alpha-synuclein, a protein associated with Parkinson's, in the appendix. Previous studies had already shown an excess of this protein in the brains of patients with Parkinson's. One of the authors of the study said that alpha-synuclein can travel through the nerve that connects the brain to the gastrointestinal tract, where the appendix is located, disseminate itself, and cause neurotoxic effects. The research also says that a study conducted by the Van Andel Research Institute analyzed the medical records of 1.6 million Swedes since 1964. Through these documents, scientists were able to separate the patients who had their appendix removed and relate the groups with or without the organ to those who developed Parkinson's. Isn't it interesting? In Parkinson's disease, toxic proteins accumulate in the brain and kill the nerves, especially the ones linked to movement. So, removing the appendix can reduce the risk of Parkinson's by 19%. It may sound weird, but according to these evidences, the digestive system is directly linked to Parkinson's. As we have already seen in the channel, the intestine is considered a second brain, and these studies certainly prove that these two organs are directly linked. Viviane Labrie, one of the researchers, says that the study's purpose is not to make people remove their appendix. On the contrary, it would be much wiser to control or reduce the excessive formation of alpha-synuclein as to decrease its overabundance or prevent it from escaping. So, if you have any digestive problems, stay tuned because we're going to talk about what you can do to improve your digestive health throughout the next couple of videos. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more recipes and tips, subscribe to the channel.